Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2439, solving a word search with Excel from the Financial Modeling World Cup. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen, a fun one for you today. This was a competition in the Financial Modeling World Cup, almost the semifinals, I think, and I was a commentator for this, and I've been thinking about the best way to solve it. It's an interesting challenge. And I think some of you might be interested in this competition. It's for people who are really good at Excel, not just financial modelers. It starts on November 13th with something at your computer. I think it takes about an hour's worth of time at your computer. And then you advance on to the head-to-head levels. I have a 50% off promo code in exchange for three answers, just simple little answers. There's a link down in the YouTube description. How old were you when you first started using Excel? I was actually 19 when I used my first spreadsheet. Multi-plan of all things. How much time do you spend working in Excel per week? 21 hours. I don't even know why those other answers are there. Who would be in there? What's your favorite Excel formula or function? VLOOKUP, XLOOKUP, I don't know. Yep. So let's dive into this. And I'm going to give you some strategy along the way. This is from a semifinal round, so it's two people head-to-head. They have 30 minutes to solve the problem. And I think that's important because this is not something that you're trying to solve over and over and over again. It's a one-time thing. So sometimes some of the robustness that we might build in wouldn't necessarily be there, all right? So they give you this workbook. You're provided with a word maze. Here in the US, we would call it a word search. 20 columns by 1,000 rows, and you have to find these words in those rows. Ah, and check this out. The question mark symbol is a wild card. It can replace any other symbol you might need. So Wally is W-A question mark L-Y. This is one of those things in these competitions. It used to be Model Off, and now the Financial Modeling World Cup. Those super hard things that they throw at you just to make your life super difficult. But, you know, in the real world, we get bad data all the time where things are super difficult. And what they have here is they have these words at different levels, and depending on which level it is, level one is left to right only. Those are worth 10 points. Left to right or top to bottom, 20 points. And then, this is the tough one, it can go backwards. So right to left, or bottom to top, those are hard. And level four, I have no idea how to solve this one. The diagonal direction, I'm just gonna tell you right now, I'm giving up on this, right? I'm not gonna try and get these points. Head to head in 30 minutes, I know that I'm just trying to beat the other person. I always have problems with diagonal. One of the very first articles I wrote at Mr. Excel way back in 1998, 1999, was meant to be funny, where I said, oh, my manager asked me to total that diagonally. And you know, a few years later, I got an email, one of the first emails that I ever received from Chip Pearson, a former Excel MVP who's no longer with us. And Chip said, you know, I know you were trying to be funny, but there is a solution for that. Made my head spin, right? So, you know, that I had flashbacks of that, and I'm just giving up on the diagonals. And then, snake, each next letter could be adjacent to the previous letter horizontally or vertically in any direction. Now, having watched several of these semifinals and finals, they make these very hard. And they give you a certain amount of time. In this case, was 30 minutes. And there's not enough time to solve the whole problem, almost universally. So when I look at this, the mistake that a lot of people made is they started to waste a lot of time on the easy ones first. So let's say that you're able to solve all the level one and level two. So I'll choose all of those. That would be worth, down here, a sum of 240 points. If instead I would dedicate my 30 minutes to trying to solve the three hard ones, that would be worth 300 points, right? So if someone gets all of those level one and level two, they have 240 points, I could have 300 points, which might be enough to win. The other thing that is massively difficult in this is the question mark, right? Because the problem is we don't know where the question mark is going to fall. So it's not like you can search for W-A question mark L-Y. You just don't know where it's going to be, right? And the first thing I did when I attacked this is thought about that question mark and how difficult that's going to make life. And I said, let's find out how many question marks there are, right? So I select all of the data. That was Control Shift down, Control Shift right, and then Control F. And it's funny, to find a question mark, you can't search for a question mark because question marks are wild card. If you're really searching for a question mark, you have to put in tilde question mark. And I think the people who designed this question are really testing to see if you know this. Right? Let's see how many question marks there are. It would be typically very hard to find this unless you know the tilde trick. And when I do find all and expand this a little bit, I find out that there's only three. The first one is the word Wally, which is an example. And then there's two more, right? So let's not worry about the question marks. In fact, let's check those question marks and see if we can just figure out what it is, right? So the first one here at N761 starts with a question mark. And just not using any Excel trickery at all, I'm looking in all directions. And the word wildcard. Wildcard is there. So that's N761 has the word wildcard, which is actually kind of funny that one of the words that we're searching for is a wildcard. So N761 right there. Hey, 20 points, I'm on the board. There were a couple of head-to-heads in the quarterfinals where it was coming down to the end of the time and no one had any points at all, right? So now if the other person is watching my score, oh yeah, they're gonna be a little worried that I already have 20 points on the board. And then I917, SP blank SE, spice, what is this? Let's come back up. So we're at I917. And right there, okay, space, I917, there we are. So don't have to worry about wildcards anymore. We've accounted for all of them. Now I'm gonna come down here and attack the three difficult ones, snake, difficult, and winner. And I asked, I said, are we allowed to use VBA? Now in this case, we had 30 minutes, and I have to tell you, I probably wasted a good 12 minutes in getting the VBA to work. And since then, I fine-tuned it. So let's just penalize me 18 minutes, which you're not gonna have to watch, thankfully. To get to the point where I could run some VBA to look for snake. When I thought about this, it's like, all right, it's not the fact that we have, what is it? It's 20,000 cells. It's not the 20,000 cells. It's only the cells that start with an S, right? Find that cell and then start to look in the directions to see if the next letter is an N. And what cells do we have to check? It's the 9 cells around us. So from an active cell, let's say from an active cell, it's active cell dot offset open parenthesis -1, -1, that moves to the cell just above me and to the left, and then dot resize 3, 3, and see if any of those are the second letter, in this case an N, right? And then keep going. All right, so I'm not particularly proud of this VBA with each loop stuck inside the other loop, but it is an effective way to go. All right, before we dive in, another thing that is super annoying, they love to use merge cells here. I have a friend who said, forget this. These merge cells are bad. And in watching people, sometimes the very first thing he did was they copied the words out and unmerged them. But then the problem is, as they start to get answers, you have to get them back in to the merged areas, all right? So getting the list of words unmerged, I actually wrote a tiny little macro to list the unfound words and unmerge them, and then another macro to go back once I have the answers in here to put them back, all right? So right now, I'm just worried about those level 5. That's what I'm gonna attack first, using my code. All right, so snake, difficult, and winner. If I go to Alt F8 for the list of macros, find them 6. And what's the 6 stand for? It's only looking for the first 6 letters, which for snake and winner is fine. But for difficult, it's only looking for D-I-F-F-I-C. Now, if they did something evil by putting difficult loo or something else, then I might get a couple of answers and I would have to go look for them. All right, so there we are with VBA. I now have the first 3 answers. And of course you wanna check, you have to check. So J793, I'm gonna go control page up, F5 for go to, J793. And I am looking for snake, right? So S-N-A-K-E right there, not in a row, but going left, right, up, down. Difficult, difficult, H940. Is particularly difficult, D-I-F-F-I-C-U-L-T. But the macro is able to find that. All right, so let's record those. Record the found words, right? And when I come back, those are recorded. Check that out, 320 points. All right, now, we're probably 16, 17, 18 minutes in. Now at this point, I can go back and actually start the Excel tricks to try and solve the level 1 items, the level 1 items. All right, so come here to sheet 2. List the unfound words. These are the words that I'm looking for. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna build a list of all the rows right here. So go back to sheet 1. And we start up there with the W in Wally, Control Shift Down Arrow, Control C to copy, and then Control V to paste. That's just to get the right number of rows in, and then equal concat, control page up. Select those 20 cells and we get the 20, and then I can double click to copy that down. All right, what's the first word we're looking for? The first word we're looking for is Financial Modeling World Cup. Anytime I need to find Financial Modeling World Cup in a large range, it's equal find. We're looking for Financial Modeling World Cup, F4, yes, definitely in the thing to our left, and we get a value error. That means it's not found there, not found. All right, so we copy that down, and somewhere, one of those, it's going to be found, all right? So how do we find the thing that's not an error? Well, this is great. The match function is throwing out all of the error cells. So we just look for a super large number, 99999, in all of those answers over there. And then here, the one, the match type is saying we're looking for the number just smaller than 99999, right? And that, because it's throwing out the errors, should tell us that what we're looking for is in the 596th row of that. We have to add 12, so that's 608. So F5, go to A608. And sure enough, there it is. There's our 9. All right, now we have to convert this to a cell address. And so that means that the word FMWC is starting at the 9th position. The 9th position, when I go look at the data over here, we know that the first letter is A. So if it was in the first position, we'd have a 1. And the letter A in ASCII code is 65. So that means that right here, to get the letter, it's equal character 65 plus the 9. 65 plus the 9. How do we get the 9? That's super easy. Index of all of those answers, I want the 596th one. Okay, this is awesome. So J608 is our first answer. And that took quite some time. What did I don't know. We'll have to check the clock on the wall back there to figure out how long it took to get to J608. But here's the beautiful thing. Right up here, I'm going to build a table, a what-if table. All right, so we're looking for J608. I want to take these words, all of these words, and plug them in one at a time into that cell and see what we get. So I select all of these, and under the data tab, hidden back here under what if analysis, a data table. This should be called sensitivity analysis, I think. And the column input cell says we're going to take these words along the left-hand column and plug them in one at a time into that cell. And there we are, bam, bam. All right, so we got all of the level ones plus bonus. You know, the level two could be down or across. There was one there, and even in the level three, all of those answers are good. And now we're down to just these right here. All right, so we've found all the things going left to right. Now we have to look for the things going top to bottom. All right, so for that, again, the concat, but this time I'm going down B13 to B1012. I end up with 20 columns of data going down. I don't like to work across. I prefer to work crossway or vertically. So I'm going to copy and paste special transpose values right there. And then here we are looking for harder, and see, it's what I found right there in the 69th row. So that's the 8th match, and building everything, it's characters this time 65 plus S12, and then figure out that 69 and get 12. That gets us our answer. All right, so we're going to rebuild our table. This time, our table is going to report the answer from I81. Select these cells, and we're going to plug them into a different cell this time. Data, what if analysis, data table. The items along the left-hand side are going to be plugged into that cell. All right, so we picked up 1, 2, 3, 4, which isn't a lot, I guess, but they're worth 20 points each, so that gives us 80 points. We'll record those found words. Level 3 and level 4. Now, level 4, I still don't know how I'm going to solve the diagonals. Level 3, though, it's just simply taking the data that's going left to right and reversing it. Excel still doesn't have a function for reverse, which is pretty annoying that they don't. There should be reverse text. Charles Williams built a reverse text into his fast Excel. But it's pretty easy to build a function called reverse. If I switch over to VBA and look for this function, it's just 5 lines of code. You should always make sure before you run an Excel custom function to close VBA. Double click to copy this down. and then Control C and then Alt ESV to paste special values. Okay, so now we're looking for the word increase and it's not found, which means that it's not a right to left. It must be a top to bottom. So we'll copy this reverse over here. Control C, Alt ESV. There it is. Okay, so it's one of the ones that's going the other direction. Losing some valuable time here. For words going left to right, this was a little bit tricky because the place where it's located, the 6, is from the right edge. That means that we have to count backwards from column V in order to locate the start position. All right, so let's build our table here again. So the answer we're trying to get is P146. And data, what if analysis, data table. The column input cell this time is right there. Click OK. All right, picked up 1, 2, 3, 4 more. We'll record those found words. Okay, and then for our table this time, we're looking for the B121, which is, and what if analysis, data table, column input cell is going to be plugging into right there, into increase. All right, we got two more recorded found words. All right, so now we're down to the diagonals, right? And I have no good solution for this at all. I can't figure out how to search diagonally. It's a super hard thing to do, so because there's so many different ways and the offset and the whole bit, right? So at this point, I got to be close to the 30 minutes. I have a score of 730. And for most people that I'd be competing head to head with, that's probably good. The people that win these competitions all the time, like Dearmid Early, probably already would have crushed me by this point. But I think the odds are pretty good that for a lot of people that in my 30-minute attempt there, including of some VBA, a score of 730 would get me really, really, really close. All right, so there you are. That's my solution. I'd have to go back and watch the video on YouTube to see the two competitors, how far they got in the 30 minutes. And I have the benefit of having seen this and, you know, probably thought about it in my head, which in the real live competition, I understand you don't have that. All right, so a couple things. First off, if you have any ideas on how to solve this diagonal thing, short of some more VBA, I guess, let me know down in the YouTube comments below. Second, if this seems something like you would be great at, if you're the go-to guy or go-to gal for Excel in your company and you're super good at Excel and you want to compete in this competition, the first round just takes an hour of your life on a Saturday. It'd be super interesting. There's a 50% off promo code down below. I have to tell you that the very first winner of the first Model Off found out about Model Off from a video on this channel, right? So if you happen to see this video and you enter and you win, that'll be a second time that the Mr. Excel YouTube channel sent the winner into the competition. We'll brag about that, of course. And hey, look, even if you don't enter, it's still great TV, right? So watch for these final rounds here, which will all be broadcast live on YouTube. Fascinating to watch. It should be on ESPN, if you ask me. Hey, if you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the YouTube comments below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.